Okay, so last but not least, I hope, my name is Alexander Garcia, and I am an ontology team leader at BASF in Germany. This is the work that we are doing together with Peter Prinz from the University of Tennessee in putting together a journal of research objects, and this is basically an experiment in fair publishing, whatever that means. So what is this really about? This is about a different kind of publication. This is about a publication which is based on Git and the Git practices. This is not a publication, but more of a release of work, a picture of the work as the work is at any given time. This is about being transparent and reproducible, and I want to emphasize on reproducible. This is about putting data, code, and content together as sort of a research object. And this is about helping to shape the knowledge graph for science, which is basically about establishing relations across different things that we produce during the research life cycle. We are focusing right now on Jupyter Notebooks. This part of the publication workflow is done. We are focusing on publishing research maps. And a research map is just a fancy word to describe a research object, which is just a bundle of things. We want to make it easy for authors to understand how a publication, a research map, or a DISCO, or a research object, whatever name you want to give it, is a publication in its own right. And we also want to be a complement by allowing or making it easier for authors to publish research objects to have a complement for existing publications. So if you have an existing publication and you want just to describe or shape or compose your research object, then you can come to our website, compose your research object, and publish that research object so that it goes to different repositories, and you, in principle, will gain visibility, or that's the hope, I guess. We also want to publish on the publications. This part, we don't yet have it clear. This is work in progress. We want to be able to publish experimental protocols. So no matter whether you have already published your experimental protocol or you're just hosting your experimental protocol anywhere in the web, we want to create a publication that is based on the automatic annotation of the experimental protocol, and it works like a metadata search engine for experimental protocols. And we want to put all of this in a scholarly wallet so that basically the idea here is that you have a research object, and the research object represents the asset that you produce throughout the research life cycle, but it's not just about the paper. And by asset, I mean something like a coin, like real money that you have to spend. And where do you put the money that you have to spend? Well, you put it in a wallet. And this is what we are building. So as for Jupyter Notebooks, we're basically using MyBinder technology. We do give VDOIs. We publish in the Journal of Research Objects, but we also publish together the Jupyter Notebook and the corresponding research object in Zenodo, Figshare, and Git. The final outcome of this publication of a Jupyter Notebook is a Jupyter Notebook as we know it, just that it has gone through a peer-reviewed publication process, which happens over Git. As for research objects, we started by thinking about this about 2 years ago, and it was mostly about considering all of the assets that are produced throughout the research life cycle, and then we thought, Why is it that we don't have research objects, any kind of research object that we produce as a publication in its own right? So we may not just have the traditional paper as a publication, which is our only asset, which we basically produce at the end of the research life cycle, but we could also have any other research asset being produced as a research object, and we could have it as a publication in its own right. And then we started wondering where could we keep those assets safe? And then we started to realize that there were very interesting similarities between cryptocurrencies and the way you manage a cryptocurrency with the way you manage these assets. We were awarded with Digital Science Innovation Grant, the Catalyst Grant, for this proposal, publishing research objects in having the ledger for science. We're currently working on that grant. And this is part of the modules of the journal that we are putting together. So basically, what do we mean by a research by a research object, or what do we mean by allowing people to map resources? It's basically that we make it easier for people just to establish relations across the different things that they produce throughout the research lifecycle. So you may produce a paper, you have a paper published, but that paper may be related to a publication that you may have in a slideshare, and that may be, that paper may also be related to code that you may have in Git. That code may be processing something that you have in Figshare, for instance. And then you may want to have a data bundle for that, which is machine processable and easily discoverable by existing search engines. And for this, we are kind of reshaping a little bit the initial research object and DISCO. DISCO is just another representation for research objects, by the way. It means distributed scholarly compound object by adding a little bit of bio schemas. The user journey is pretty easy. We assume that users will always be able to use whatever repository they want to use. So we are not a repository. We're just a metadata bundle facility. So you come out to our website, you authenticate using your ORCID, you authenticate as in your Git or in your Figshare, and then you start claiming your things, and then you start defining the relations across your things, and then you off you go. Once you're happy with that, you publish it. You publish the bundle of things over Zenodo, or you can export it, or you can just leave it in our website where it will be searchable. We want to. We also want to establish the value through the publication workflow. And what I mean by establishing the value through a publication workflow is simply that very often the publication workflow only adds value to the author of the published paper, but it doesn't give any credit to the actual editor, and it doesn't give any credit to the reviewers. So we want to make sure that whatever assets you generate throughout the review process are accurately described and accurately accounted for. And we, for that, we have this idea of the ledger for science, which is something that we are that we have already developed in the form of a scholarly wallet, where we are keeping track of all of these assets that you create. So basically, what happens is that when you create the asset, you basically come to our website, you describe your asset whatever way you want with control vocabularies, you establish the relations across your assets, and then you have those assets in your own scholarly wallet, which are immediately available for anyone to review. But most importantly, the idea that the asset is referenceable and decomposable means that at any given point in time, the research object, which is just a bundle of things, will be easy to understand for anyone who wants to come and look at what you have produced. So for this specific paper, you have produced all of these different assets, and that's a data bundle. But you may have another data bundle for another research object. And you can just decompose that by looking at the scholarly wallet of any researcher who has that scholarly wallet with us. For the biohackathon, we want to understand better what is the editorial workflow for research objects. This is something that we have seen that is not so straightforward as when you publish a paper, which is just one single research object. How can we better semanticize the connections across different research objects? And what is the role of the interplanetary file system in making those research objects widely available? For Jupyter notebooks, although this is a more clear workflow for us, we also want to validate the publication workflow that we have implemented. We also want to understand how can we simplify the work of the editor, meaning how can we automate some of the processes that aren't undertaken by the editor, and how can we use automatic annotation for the content of the Jupyter notebook so that we can also publish automatic annotations together with the data bundle that goes with the publication. Also, we want to understand how do research objects and Jupyter notebooks come together in the publication. Needless to say that we are supporting Python as well as we are supporting R, and in the future we would like also to support the publication of Galaxy workflows. So that's pretty much what I wanted to share with you. So we would like to publish the research objects and the Jupyter notebooks for this biohackathon as an experiment. Anyone who wants to work with us on that, just contact me or Piotr. We also want to understand what do we mean by having a third publication, which is not entirely clear to me. And as a side note, because I also have an interest in ontologies in chemistry, if anyone has an interest in discussing the lack of ontologies in chemistry, and how can we address that? Please talk to me, because this is something that I am also interested in discussing here. Thank you.